on the Fox video thing. We're amazed I wasn't in it, just kind of shocked. They've had over a year to put it out, so I don't know. Somebody probably got fired over it, or should. There's a couple of things where it's just mind-boggling. It's like, really? How do you forget that? It doesn't make sense to me. It's amazing that a fella who's won 4 of 8 majors has like the biggest chip on his shoulder. And it's, you know, it hasn't been softened even slightly or dented slightly because of this stuff. Someone tweeted to me saying this video is like a year old and they sent him the wrong video, but I haven't seen any other person say that. So I actually do think it is the 2019 Fox preview.
Even if it was a year old, though, yeah. He was also defending champion, champion last year.
Been all over it, you know, defending champion. But whoever made it, never mind them, whoever reviewed it to let it go out should be absolutely shot.
Is he just looking for a chip in his shoulder at this stage?
But like you win a
this
tournament.
Was one promo out of several Fox promos. Now, you would assume, and we all put together montages and different things whereby if you're doing that, the first thing you do is look and you put in last year's
champion
holding that winning putt. And again, maybe the difficulty is you're looking for emotion. You're looking for, maybe the promo was all about the emotion of winning the US Open and all the famous celebrations and Graham McDowell's dad running onto the green to celebrate rather than the old shrug of the shoulders from Brooks Koepka when he won it last year.
Maybe they're trying to sell to a mainstream audience. Mm. Name golfers: Phil, Tiger, Rory, Jordan Spieth. There's your minute done. Bye. Oh crap, Brooks. That's what happened.
Well, what was McDowell doing in there then?
That's just Nathan. I don't know if he was in it, was he?
No, I have no idea, but I'm saying that
he was in it.
Yeah, but he won the last US Open in Pebble Beach. I'm just saying there could be a...
He did. 2010.
Sorry, he did, yes.
Yeah, apologies. I'm just saying that it could well have been a iconic US Open moment.
Sure.
Of which Brooks Koepka has not had one over the last couple of years.
Now look, on balance, even if he's pointless, and even if like a mainstream audience are like, oh, there's Tiger, Phil, Rory, Jordan Spieth, cool. Who's that guy? You just put him in holding the trophy. So even the uninitiated know. Oh, well, he's
sure
clearly the champion.
Now. He's won 4 majors in the last 8.
Peter, I'm not being funny. Brooks Koepka could walk into this office in his golf gear, and I'd say, if you had half the room know who he is, I'd be shocked. Maybe 3/4.
Oh, I would be.
Wouldn't know.
Half, there's no way in hell half would know.
If Tiger walked
Tiger Woods walked in.
Are you telling me everybody would recognize him?
Tiger could walk in his civvies and everyone would know him. I'm saying if Brooks Koepka walked in his Nike hat and his golf gear.
Okay.
Carrying a 6-iron.
Maybe even with a golf
Ricky
bag.
Ricky Elliott on the bag.
Maybe even with a golf bag that said Koepka on it. I still don't think people would know. Sorry, Ivan Yates has previewed every major with me this year.
Right.
Every single time. And Koepka? Is he?
I actually listened to it. I thought he was hilarious yesterday.
Well, he's getting better, but he still doesn't know the guy's name.
No.
So,
I thought he was funny with Shane, about Shane Larry.
Oh, yeah.
Well, there's history.
Yeah. Well, no, that's what we talked about.
Like he brought it up.
So Shane called me a bollocks, didn't he? Yeah, he did, yeah. In fairness, he was not the only one. Fox, are we angry on Brooks Koepka's behalf, Fionn?
No. The thing is, Koepka's right.
Yeah, sure.
I mean,
yeah.
But as Nathan pointed out, there's lots of promos with him in it. Just it's the general promo, for whatever reason, they don't have him in it. It's, as you say, it's obviously an oversight. So he's right. He should be included. He's won the last 2. He's going for a three-peat. He is the current US Open champion. There's all the reasons. But here's the thing. Shut up about it.
Mm.
Like, have some dignity. Have some grace. Like, stop being such a whiny little cow. Like...
Oh.
That's what he... Like, I'm sorry. I have to
get another interview again.
Yeah.
Nah, to hell with him. Like, I thought his...
But we like Ricky Elliott, right?
Yeah, Ricky Elliott's great. No, but it's like, he's right. But just because you're right doesn't... Like, for him... I'm sorry, Peter. I'm going to disagree with you. But for him to say that someone should be fired...
Mm, I thought that was too far.
Dude, you're a millionaire many times over. Some young person working at Fox's... You know, been told, get that promo together. And what, they should be fired because your feelings have been hurt? Stop being such a whiny little cow.
I agree with that. I calling for someone's job or putting that kind of pressure is terrible.
And I'm sure, and I'm also, I am sure, in hindsight, Koepka goes, okay, I didn't actually mean I want to see someone fired. Maybe it's just an angry turn of phrase. But it's like, but this, Koepka has form and he... To a certain degree, is correct. It's like he isn't given the media attention that perhaps his ability deserves or his accomplishments deserve. But there's a reason for it, and it goes back to the Graham McDowell argument. This is that Graham McDowell is smart enough to know is this is how you play the game.
Mm.
Brooks Koepka doesn't play the game. And listen, I've just spent the last 2.5 weeks in California. Like, I'm not kidding. Golf is an incidental occurrence in the sporting calendar. The U.S. Open is incidental to the NBA Finals. It's not a big deal. Sure. I didn't see, like, a huge amount of prep. And if you're going to be, you guys mentioned Phil, Tiger, if you're going to be the guys that kind of rise above just like that small world of golf, you got to do more than be surly at interviews. And for Koepka not to know that, that's his fault.
It's not the media's fault. The kid not invited to someone's birthday in class, going on about it forever.